Hi, it's Steve. In this video, we'll help you troubleshoot why your refrigerator may not be cooling at all. We'll discuss some of the components that may cause that symptom, where they're located, and how to test them. Now, the first step in this diagnosis would be to determine whether or not we have power to the refrigerator. The simplest check is simply to open the door up and see if the lights come on internally. If so, we know that we do have power to the appliance. And then we can move on to the next step. If no lights come on in your refrigerator, we may suspect that either we have burned out light bulbs or the receptacle itself may have no power to it. At that point, you would want to plug in another appliance into that receptacle to verify that you do have power. Now, our next step will be to determine whether or not the fans in the refrigerator and the compressor are running. If you don't hear any fans running, you may suspect that we have a problem with the controls. On a standard refrigerator with a dial type control or a slide type control, there is basically an on-off switch in here that turns power onto the compressor and the fans. If neither of those are running, we can suspect a problem with the control. Now, on models that use electronic controls, you'll either need a good understanding of how those controls work, or you'll need to contact a technician to troubleshoot it further. Now, if the fans on your refrigerator are running, but not the compressor, we may suspect a problem with the start device for that compressor. Most compressors use either a relay overload device or a start device to get that compressor running. Those components can normally be tested with a multimeter to check for their proper function. Without the start device working properly, the compressor may not start and therefore you would not get any cooling. Now, most of these are easily checked with a multimeter. You would simply pull that device completely off of the compressor. Now, the three typical components of a relay start device would be the capacitor. It may be called either a run capacitor or a start capacitor. About the only thing that you can check on these is to verify that they're not shorted. And the numbers will typically rapidly change and then go to a overscale condition or an overload condition. That test simply means that that capacitor is not shorted and is not open. Now next on this device would be the overload. The purpose of the overload is to protect the compressor from starting and stopping mid-cycle with pressures built up on it. So there should be continuity between the two sets of terminals on that device, the one terminal that attaches to the compressor and the external terminal. They should show somewhere close to 0 ohms. Now the next portion of that device is the relay. Now the purpose of the relay portion of this device is to activate both the start and run windings on the compressor, and once the compressor comes up to speed, the start winding will get dropped out so that it does not draw too much current. Typically they will use some type of a thermistor or varistor device internally, so there will be some continuity between these two terminals. If there isn't, we can assume that that device is defective. Now, other styles of relays may look like this. Internally, we basically have some type of a varistor that would measure continuity between both sides. As they heat up, they would go to a very high resistance and drop out that start winding. Some very new styles of these devices use little electronic control boards internally, and these are very difficult to check with a multimeter without extensive knowledge of how that circuit works. And lastly, you may find that your refrigerator has an inverter drive style of compressor, which would have this type of a box mounted to the side of the compressor. This performs the same function as the start device, with the exception that it also has the ability to operate a variable speed compressor. Again, these are a very difficult device to troubleshoot without extensive knowledge of the circuits. Now, the last check we would make would be on the compressor itself. We can actually test the internal windings on that compressor to verify that they are in working order. We'll find three male pins on the side of that compressor. Typically the one at the top would be our common terminal, and the other two would represent both the start and run windings. So measuring between the common terminal and each of the remaining two terminals would indicate that they all have continuity. The start winding typically has a higher resistance than the run winding. We would also look for any continuity between these three pins and ground, or the case of the compressor. So simply find a spot that you can scratch through the paint and make sure that there is no continuity between any of those terminals. If so, the compressor is shorted and would need to be replaced, which would require a certified technician to do that repair. Now, if both the evaporator and condenser fans are running and the compressor is running and you still are not getting any cooling in your refrigerator, you can suspect that you have a sealed system problem, and that will require a qualified technician to perform a proper diagnosis. Need help with anything else around your home? Search our channel for thousands of helpful videos that will walk you through your home repairs. For more information or the parts needed for these repairs, don't forget to check out partselect.com. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to subscribe.